Hello.
Drew.
How are you doing?
Well, thank you.
You all right?
Find us okay?
I mean, we drove up, you can't see any of this.
Completely hidden, which is great. We're very private, but people do get to know where we are and they come back year after year.
So they come back with a forklift, mostly?
Yeah. Yes, they can, if ours won't start.
Today, I'm at Spencer Architectural and I didn't know this place existed. I've just driven up. You can't see it. And we're in this incredible building. Come through the door there and you're greeted with this. And this is a proper salvage yard. It's full of original architectural elements, pieces of building material. I'm just staggered by the volume and the quality. That's pretty fabulous thing, isn't it?
Yeah.
That one's had the top changed, obviously.
But as a pair, they're quite unusual.
They are, aren't they? What are they worth?
I'm asking 1,500 for that one and 1,000 for that one.
Oh, my God. Such a shame about that top.
It is.
Have you orientated it correctly or has you just dumped it?
No, at the moment it's not.
Are we early or late, according to that?
According to that, it's 10 past 12.
It's only 5 past 11.
Right, there you go. Well, keep looking around. It's great.
We bought a floor out of a church at Uppingham 15 years ago. And when we lifted the floor, it was old tombstones. I think it's late Georgian.
As ever, I'm dipping into the early stuff whenever I can. And there is a grave marker here that Barry reclaimed as a floor, as a section of a floor. It's a minimum of early 18th century. Minimum. It could be, I can't read it at the moment, so I'm not entirely sure. It's the most wonderful colour. It's got this fabulous mask with wings coming off it. And then this acanthus crestings in the corner. Just beautiful.
The practice of using tombstones for persons of note inside a church as flooring or decorative pieces set into the wall was commonplace in centuries gone by. The whitest tone of this stone comes from the material from which it's carved, Ancaster Quarry, which is local to Lincolnshire. It could be worth around £350.
What are you asking for that?
That would be 75.
£75?
Yeah.
Sold.
Okay.
I don't know what on earth I'm going to do with it, but £75, I want it. That's why you should come to salvage yards. Don't buy new. What's the point? Look at that. Imagine having to commission that today. Imagine just having to buy the piece of sandstone. But this has a naivety to it and a colour and the pattern that it has. For £75, I cannot leave that there. It's beautiful.
That came from Beaver Castle.
Did it?
Yep.
Did it really?
Yep. It was bought out of the local scrapyard. They said you wouldn't believe it, but the manager from Beaver Castle has just brought that in.
You're kidding me.
Mm. Yeah.
That's like one of the most historically important buildings in the country.
I know.
This thing is called an overthrow. So you're driving through the entrance to your house, you have your pillars up the side, and then you have this beautiful piece across the top. It can be stone, it can be wrought iron, it can be marble, it can be cast iron, it can be timber, it can be all sorts of things. That's a wrought iron one there with some really extraordinary work going on in it. Then Barry goes, that's from Beaver Castle. Now you've got my attention.
Beaver Castle in Grantham was originally built in the 11th century, and this ornate overthrow would have nestled neatly amongst its fairy tale turrets and towers. This piece dates from around the 1840s and is the work of a fine craftsman. With clear provenance, it could be worth around £3,800.
What do you value that at?
£250.
I'm going to buy that.
Okay.
Thank you very much. And I've got the best blacksmith in the world. So
brilliant.
Nev, I can give that to him and he can go to town on that. What a thing. Wonderful. It's worth coming for that alone. Where did you get these from?
Well, that came from Grantham many years ago. It's got parked here and never moved.
That's extraordinary, isn't it? How much are they?
£250 for that.
Right. £400 a pair?
£425.
Sold.
Okay.
Can we have a look at those sundials again?
We can.
How long have you had them?
3 years.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's just such a shame. It's just missing two major components, and that top that's on it is just not helping it at all, is it? The piece that really makes them is as you have this sort of stepped pedestal coming up, and it comes to the socle, and then up from there is this beautiful cushion, like a stone cushion with this sort of pattern, and it's running all the way around both of them, and it's still crisp, and it just makes them. It's that tiny detail like that that sets certain things apart, and that matters, and that has them.
This pair of sundials with pedestals came from a local stone-built mansion. They were made in the 18th century by a skilled stonemason who carved each element from a single piece of stone. The original dial and stone top has been replaced on one of them, but nevertheless, they are in fabulous condition with exceptional colouring and detail. They could be worth around £6,000.
What about this one for a grand?
I can't do it at a grand, no.
Can I be really cheeky? 1,500 quid the pair.
No, can't do it.
Worth that, worth asking.
Yeah, yep. That's the odd of the deal. If we take it up, it'll immediately be worth more money.
Yeah, as soon as you take that off, it's gonna look better.
Yeah. Is it coming?
There you go. It's better without that.
A lot better.
One last bid, 1,700 quid. And that's me done.
Can't quite do it. 1,750 I could do.
50 quid?
Yeah.
I'm not going to argue with you for 50 quid. Sold.
OK.
They're great. They give me the shiver. I like them a lot.
That's good.
If I had the other top to them, I think we'd be looking at £10,000 to £12,000 for the pair. I think that would be the reality. I think with a reproduction or new top on that one, probably half that. But still, as an item in your garden, that's stellar. That was 300 quid, grab you.
3 1/4 and it's yours.
Sold.
Okay.
I'll take my chances.
Yep, okay.
We have Bacchus, a mask of Bacchus. Plaster, I think. It's been outside for a very, very long time. It's an extraordinary size, caked in paint. It's a piece of wall decoration, probably part of a set. Has it come off a pair of gates? Has it come out of a restaurant? Who knows? We'll never know. My God. There's not many things that I've seen that have completely stopped me in my tracks, but these have.
Mm. Yeah.
So. They are just wonderful. Look how good they are.
Yeah.
Can I get a bit closer?
Yeah, come by all means.
These are just unbelievable. Look at that. Look at that. And then he shows me something which I have never seen the like of. And it's a pair of carved, again, a form of sandstone, one of the sandstones, pair of grotto chairs. Some things, right, have got magic to them. They're extraordinarily rare. These are off the scale rare. These are stellar.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
I paid 750 for the pair.
750 pence.
Yeah, yeah.
I think I'd happily pay you 20,000 for them today. Mm.
I know
I'll write the cheque.
No, not at the moment.
Sure.
No, I'll consider that. When my next divorce goes through, I'll...
Remember me. I would love to. They need to go to somebody who understands them. They're unbelievable.
They're lovely.
Yeah,
I've never seen any, ever.
No,
nothing like them. Extraordinary. Unbelievable. I would love to own them, and I would do exactly what Barry's doing and never sell them.
Do you want us to leave you alone with the chairs for a bit?
Oh, just. I mean, they've even got a faux cushion.
Well, the day was great, actually. It was great fun. There are not that many people around that are doing exactly what I and Drew do in today's world. So, yeah, he's a great character. I like him a lot.
Today, a fantastic day, doing one of my absolute favourite things, which is bashing around an old architectural salvage yard. And we just happened to find probably the most interesting one in the country. Genuinely beautiful architectural items of real merit stacked on top of each other, completely untouched and unrestored. You do not get to see that very often these days, and that is pretty damn wonderful. I'm over the moon.